all my shepherds and my brethren, Brother Riggins, Hamed, everybody. I think that's our sister Marcia on everybody who's on the line.
And we have on Zoom, we have on WhatsApp, we have the bishop on WhatsApp, Sister Helen and they on WhatsApp, and other people on WhatsApp. Yes.
Good morning. Pleasant good morning to you, Sister Helen, Sister Brenda, everybody. A pleasant good morning, Sister Barbara. Wonderful, this course is wonderful.
Oh, yes.
I thank God this morning. I would like us to sing. We have heard a joyful song, Jesus saves.
All right.
I don't know if you'll have it. In
that,
my book is 100, I don't know in the other book
what it
would be.
All right, yeah, lead us with it because I'm not sure we know it too well. I've heard the wondrous song, Jesus saves.
Good, the joyful song.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, good, the joyful song.
But it was a time when sent to revival services.
Oh, yes.
Holidays, you know, your parents, your grandparents send them to revival meetings. And I remember clearly as a little child, the teachings we got, you know, the lessons we had and the stories were told, it was something that touched our lives quite early. Because the children of circumstances.
Oh, yes.
You know, I saw him as a loving, a friend, as a shelter, saw him as a passionate, understanding person.
My God.
Nobody feels your pain. Nobody hears your cry.
My God.
He feels and he hears.
Amen. My God.
I remember that feeling him up to this hour.
Oh, yes.
Because, you know, sometimes we get baptized and we become older, you know.
My God.
Getting to know Jesus at an early age, an advantage. There is something that registers in your spirit that grows with you. Matures with you that it comes and happens.
My God.
It choose to meet you in life. You have this blessed assurance that he's there.
Oh yes.
Today he's there to deliver. He's there to uphold you.
My God.
I might be saying also this morning, but because I think it's so deeply on this matter.
Yes, yes, yes.
One thing that he is such a lover. He's really a lover of your life, lover of your soul. And he could only truly of what you get from him.
My God.
He really truly tell others that he is love, strength, his mercy.
Oh, yes.
Everything. You know, when he said, God is everything to me.
My God.
You understand from where you are coming. People may not understand the depth of your love. You know, you may have ways or situations that meet us, and I just say, you know, well, just say, well, this person do or whatever. But in us, a compassion, that spirit, that nature is inborn in us.
Oh, yes.
That we cannot be part of them because it becomes now a part of our growing life and nature. And so when we get that into us, we know that there's no hopelessness in life. No matter what come, what times will change, what situation can meet you. When I learned to understand in my growing years that times, you know, when I look back, why things will have grown anyway.
My God.
You see that He grooms us. He grooms us for times like unto these where we will be able now to give others hope.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, just as how Peter and John was able now to tell this beggar, listen, get up, rise up and walk.
Rise up, man.
Be able now to give command to situations.
Oh, yes.
That is not ours. You know, we might, some of ourselves, we might even take it on, but we will have that strength.
Oh, yes.
Have that anointing.
My God.
That virtue. That when we approach any situation that looks downcast, because as the psalm said, He lift up the poor and the needy out of the downhill.
Yes.
When we meet people in those conditions, we can address it with authority.
My God.
The powerful name of Jesus Christ. You see, because he is someone who demonstrates, He came from above, just passed away. His word of life, His word of power, and His word is what brought the change in lives. We know that when we have that life-saving word in us, because He Himself is a word. When you have that word of light and the word of love and the word of power, that word becomes an essence in us, a true nature, that it conforms. You see, unless my word does not abide in you and you in me, unless I don't abide in you and you don't abide in me, that I am not, that you are not of me. So that you're able now to fill those places and walk and do what He has us to do. To be missionaries like Peter and John. We will walk with the bodies and the authority to give and to witness for Him what He wants us to do as children and citizens of the kingdom of heaven. Today, you know, I would like to tell my brethren, you know, I feel so good hearing Sister Barbara.
My God.
And it's because she could address all of us. Our situations are not meant to make us less than anybody.
Oh,
it's
yes.
not meant to make us feel that we are lost. It's not to make us. It's not meant to make us feel that we are dumb, that we are unable to come up. We are dumb in our vision. No, it is meant to strengthen us, to be able to equip us to be the vessels God wants us to be. I want to tell you, when I look at the Canaanite woman, Jesus, He was going through, the way He administered to people, He healed the blind and the dumb and the deaf. He raised Jairus' daughter. He did so much miracles, He did so many things, and then people heard from John the Baptist, behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world. He is greater than I. He is the one that I was telling you about, that the latchet of His shoes I'm not able to unlace. This is the one I've been telling you and preparing you for. This great God of heaven, this great Messiah, the one who came but filled with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit came down as a dove to be a witness that He came from heaven as the Son of God and even the Son of Man, to come to bring a new life, a new change to the whole scenario. Because many people are just groping in the pains and in darkness and having the sacrifices and doing the sacrifices for the remission of their sins and for healing and for deliverance and for thing, but He came with a mission.
My God.
He came to enjoin us to the heavenly kingdom. And to die. You say, my whole reason for coming is to die for the fallen race. The whole reason for coming is to bring new light into darkness.
Oh, yes.
Men are still groping in darkness, but I came that men may see the light, that they have life. And life more abundantly. And the abundant life was a life that was in God, a life in the Spirit, a life that was able to commune with God as friend with friend. A life that we didn't have to no more make sacrifices. A life that was free from burdens. Where He can come and break down barriers with such a life. in Christ, being born in Him, being washed in His blood, a blood that was shed for the remission of our sins, we were able now to have a divine and a one-on-one connection. Oh, yes. So that like Peter and John, we were left, as He said, the works that I do here, greater works that I have done, He will do. You know. So when they showed a my woman, well, she was in the time of old, but the Canaanite woman.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, in the midst as the other people who were burdened, barriers in the way, who were looking for some hope, who were looking for some way out of distress.
Oh, yes.
Who were there wanting some kind of deliverance, who were there looking for answers. They had to fight up with the Roman soldiers. Oh, they had to fight up with the Pharisees and the scribes and the big short way and walking with all the things to the dangling and making the people feel inferior. That there's no hope, you know, they're down at the end of the barrel. But today we know that Jesus Christ came and He took away all of that to show them, listen,
oh, yes.
In me there is life.
Oh yes.
In me there is hope. In
true.
Me there is deliverance. In me there is strength. Praise in me there is lifting up.
Oh yes.
You know, when even the dead, when the people saw that He could even raise the dead, they marvel and wonder what kind of man this is. Jesus Christ is still the same as yesterday, today, and forever. He's the same God, same miracle working God. And
oh, my God.
We are receiving miracles every day without even realizing we're receiving miracles.
Truly.
It's taken a long while, and we're asking and we're praying, we're saying, Lord, why? Like, Lord, what? Lord, this, Lord, that. But when He eventually comes to realize, He is His way. You know, we tend to say, have that own way, God will not have that own way. For we are the pot, you are the potter and we are the clay. You know, mold me and make me after thy will. While I am waiting, have your own way.
My God.
If you can see with the passage of time what He's really doing. Because at the instant, we cannot see it.
True.
Good. But when you say, press on, believer, press on. Trust on, believer, trust on. And as I said this little thing, it, as I told you a few moments, Jesus saves.
Jesus saves.
And to someone who is in condition, you know, condition like a dark and dreary and without hope and without any seeming breakthrough. But that's what Jesus saves.
Oh, yes. Jesus saves
is a word that builds your confidence.
Oh,
is
yes.
A word that builds your strength. And surely, yes, He has shown me, there is no hopelessness in serving Him and in trusting Him. I have seen it work.
Truly.
Year after year.
Oh, Master Lord.
I came to relieve the oppressed. I came to deliver from captive's chains.
Oh,
I came as He released the man in the tomb from Legion. He released him from all his powers of hell. And He got me rid of it and sent it into the swine.
Oh, my
he
God.
Miracle that He helped a man whose son was catching epilepsy all the time. Falling down all about and floating. He released the man, He released the son, and He brought healing and deliverance. Today, brethren, it's the same Jesus we serve.
Oh, yes.
It's the same one when we apply ourselves.
Oh,
when we apply ourselves to enter this word, we cannot get it, we can't reach into it, we can't feed on His word unless we don't really study this word.
Oh, yes.
Unless we did not. Molded in trials and tribulation, unless we then go through fiery trials and tribulation.
Oh, yes.
Unless we then prove Him beyond the shadow of a doubt that He's alive and He's real and His power is real and He's
at work.
If we did not do it, we would not be able to truly understand that He has the power to use us, that there's nothing called hopeless.
Oh, yes.
We can make our boats, we can witness to each other. All of us, have gone through things.
True.
All of us have gone through things to let us know that in Him there is hope, in Him there is life. With Him all things are possible. In Him there is mercy. In Him there is everything. He is all. You know, it says that Jesus is all in all to me. My life, my hope, my friend, He's all. So today I want us to keep on believing and trusting even as we do the Zoom here, it's when we get together, because one, two, three, we get together around one person to pray about that situation. One will have a different effect on the other, but together, we can accomplish this thing that God wants us to accomplish. Peter and John were walking together.
Oh, yes.
And Peter was able to say in confidence, look on us. He didn't say, look on me. He said, look on us.
Look on us, man.
Look on us. Because in us, there's a strength and there's a bond, and there's a binding. There's a powerful cord that cannot be broken.
Look on us.
And what we have to see and say, what we have to give to you is more than you could understand.
Oh, yes.
Thank God today that as we gather together, we will realize it's not you, and it's not you, and it's not you, it's all of us.
Oh, yes.
That we have a task to accomplish for Almighty God, that we'll go boldly, speak boldly, and work boldly in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to accomplish that which He has left in us and that which He has born in us by the might and the power of the Holy Spirit. For He is God and God alone. He is a King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, you know, King of Wise and Eternal.
Oh, yes.
And of Judah, King of Israel, Savior of the world, Jesus Christ is the name. So God bless us all, and may have a way. May continue to bless us as we go through. Minister unto us His grace and His mercy in Jesus' almighty name. Amen.
Praise. Wonderful words, you know, and you know, it could bring our wandering spirit back. Because you see, if we felt, you know, hopeless, and many of us would have gone through situations like that, you know, we can attest to that, right? But we know that Jesus is there to renew that hope within us. You know, when Jesus is in our life, it takes on a new meaning. And this is what the speakers have been telling us. All right, but I wouldn't deliberate because we have Shepherd Gerard to do the overview. After that, we have Bishop to warm our hearts to join us. You know, he will lead in worship, right? Because I want to say, let us gear up ourselves because next week, please God, right? The invitation is going out. We are going back to church so that we can all be together, you know, in one accord. Because you see, sometimes people get trouble on Zoom, they there, you know, and they don't know that we they might talk or to pray. Alright? But when we go back together, we'll be, you know, in the spot where we'll be able to do whatever. In Jesus' almighty name. So Shepherd Gerard, all to you in Jesus' name at this point in time.
And a pleasant and good day to all. To all in the house of God. You. We'll meet Jesus by and by. During our lifetime, in our families, in our friendships,
the relationships that we have in our workplaces and everywhere that we toil.
My God.
We have seen and experienced the hardships. Lots of hard times. Some of us can talk to that. Others can bear witness.
My God.
But also,